and welcome to Coffee with My Sunshine. Today's video is going to be a fall compilation video of all my favorite DIY decor pieces that we've done together, and I'm going to start with these cute little acorns that I made from Easter eggs. And I was actually inspired to do these acorns by some that I saw when I was at a consignment shop recently. So I decided to use some Easter eggs that I had on hand because they were kind of the shape that I wanted. And I just went ahead and sprayed them. These are the colors that I used. I wanted more like natural colors-ish. I guess bronze. I guess copper and black aren't really natural colors, but they're really pretty for fall anyway. So I did a gray, black, iodized bronze, and copper. And then you can use any ribbon or rope or twine that you want. And you're also going to need pine cones, which after trying this kind of pine cone, it didn't work out very well. I was pulling and tugging and they were just breaking. They would not release from this pine cone for some reason. So you're going to want to go back to the bigger ones, which I don't have a lot of these around my yard, but I had this one in my fall stash. So I just started yanking on the little pieces, and I had to get the pliers and start pulling on them. So first I started off with the gray egg, and you can use, like I said, any color you want. And I'm just using a little bit of hot glue to secure these little pieces from the pine cones. And you're just going to kind of layer them on top of each other and stagger them. Kind of to give it that acorn top look. This one I did, it was a little bit taller than I wanted to do, but I still think it turned out kind of cute and unique. And then for the top pieces, all I did was bend them, like bend the top part, not where you glue, but the top part, bend it, so that it kind of gives you a flatter surface on the top to glue the rest on so that it's covered and rounded. And then you can just use the same stem from the pine cone and glue that on top. And make sure you pull those little hot glue strings off. And then for the black one, I thought I wanted a little bit of pop of color on there. So I did the gold ribbon and same thing here, just hot glued it. And you're gonna wanna probably just do little dots of hot glue because I, you know, went around the whole egg when I was doing it, and you can see the dried hot glue after you're done. And then once you get to the top, just leave a little hole so you can put the stem in and then hot glue and wrap the ribbon around the stem. And because I could see all that hot glue mess, I'm just going to go ahead and do a second layer of the ribbon and try and do a little bit less of the hot glue so you can't really see it. And for this next one, I wanted more texture, kind of like those ones I showed you in the picture in the beginning. So I'm going to take some twine and do like a little loop and glue it on this way. And after I was finished, I thought when I have time next time, I'm going to actually add some more layers just like these, you know, the same loops and stuff, but a little bit shorter so that it kind of gets smaller as it gets to the top, but I want more of the egg covered. But for this, I'm just showing you one layer of it. And you're just going to hot glue them all the way around. Here I'm just making sure all the pieces are the same size. And then I actually ended up just, after I used all those up, just using the twine connected to the, you know, the whole bunch and just doing like little swirls and gluing it that way. And then you can put a stem on this one too, but I just used the excess twine on the top and kind of twirled it up. And like I said, I'm going to add some more layers of it so it looks more finished. For the next copper one, I just took some gold ribbon because I wanted a little bit of sparkle to this one too, and just wrapped it halfway up the top of the egg, and then I did the same thing with the pine cone and added more of the pieces, just like we did on the other one for the acorn topper. And same thing when you get to the top, kind of fold them so that you have a flat surface on the top. And go ahead and secure a stem on there. And this is what they look like finished. So I hope you guys are enjoying this video as much as I enjoyed making it. These are some of my favorite fall DIY decor pieces that we've done. And since I know so many of you are huge fans of these farmhouse candles like I am, I just wanted to show you because I love when this shows up at my doorstep. Their fall farmhouse candles are out right now, and I think it's so awesome. I think the packaging is so adorable, and I love that they got rid of the packing peanuts. I don't know if that's how they're going to package them going forward, but I love this. It's so clean and not a lot of waste, but I just wanted to show you. Their fall candles are some of my most favorite, and I know a bunch of you like them. So I will have my link listed in the description box if you guys are interested in ordering yours. So let's get back into the video. For this next one, it is one of my favorite. I've shared with you a couple times. It is these little pumpkins made from grocery bags. So for this, I just took the old sock and filled it with a good amount of old grocery bags. You could use stuffing here too, but I thought since we're recycling things, why not use grocery bags? And then you just cut it and seal it with a little bit of hot glue and squish it around to make it round again. Then take some twine and play around with the placement until you like how it looks. We're going to be making it look like a pumpkin, obviously. And then you cut off the excess twine, and you're going to want to push it down here and there just to make sure it's going to sit flat. And then I used just a stick that I had from the backyard and broke it. And you can add some greenery if you want. This pumpkin is one I did last year just with some excess fabric that I had and twine, and I don't know if you can hear it, it's also filled with grocery bags. And for this one, we're just going to use an old sweater. And I'm going to use the sleeve of it. And the same with the sock. I tied off the end because obviously you need, it's going to be open on both ends, but I tied it with some twine. And I thought as I was doing this, it actually looked like those plastic wrapped candies that, you know, are out around Christmas time or whatever, but I thought that would be a cute idea also. But anyway, we're going to go ahead with the pumpkin theme, and then you just cut off the extra fabric on the top and bottom. And don't worry if it's not sitting flat right now, because once you wrap it with the twine, it makes kind of like a flat bottom. And then you're going to do the same as we did with the sock and just make little, you know, plump sections like a pumpkin. And I think this one looks really cute. I love the texture of it. And I'm going to show you what it looks like with just a little bit of greenery, like a leaf, and another piece of stick. I thought it looked cute like that. And here it is without the greenery. And this is probably how I'll display it around fall. I think that looks really cute, and I'll probably make probably a bunch more of these because I think they're so cute.
I decided to do these really cute concrete pumpkins. They're really simple and cheap, and all you'll need is a bag of concrete, water, gloves, a spoon, nylons, and twine or string. And all you have to do is fill the nylon with the concrete and use the twine to create the little chubby grooves of the pumpkin. Let the concrete dry for about 24 hours or as long as the directions say on the bag. One of the pumpkins that I didn't let it dry long enough, so when I removed the nylon, it was super crumbly and fell apart on the top. So I had to add some cement around the top, and then when it dried, I just sanded it down to the shape that I wanted, which was fairly simple, but it's easier if you just have patience and let it dry. And then after it's dry, you cut the string carefully and remove the nylon, and you have a cute little pumpkin that you can paint, stain, or leave bare. Add a stem, and you are all set.
Today's video is going to be super fun. I'm going to show you how I made two different rustic type pumpkins and a two-tier tray. Also how I decorated it for really, really cheap. The items we're going to be using for our projects today, they are mostly thrift store items. We're going to be using these wicker plate baskets, these two chargers, usually you can get them at the Dollar Tree or whatever. These spindle, I think they're called spindles, I'm not really sure, and some books. So first we're gonna start off. My husband did this part for me, so thank you. He measured to the center of the wicker plates, or wicker baskets, and cut out the center for me on the bottom one. It's going to be the bottom part of our two-tier tray. This was a lot more work than I thought it would be, but he did it. He also took this spindle thing and cut it so that it was flat, because it wasn't to begin with. So we put it in there and it would fit nice and tight. You can add some glue. And originally I didn't think I wanted this to be a permanent two-tier tray, so I didn't screw them together. I just used a high heat hot glue gun. But if you wanted it to be permanent, you just drill a hole right there and then put a screw in to go through the plastic charger and up to the spindle leg. But like I said, I didn't think I wanted it to be permanent, but after seeing it done, I think I'm going to be putting a screw in it. But it holds really, really well with the high heat hot glue gun. Next, we're going to take the next charger, and like I said, you could put a screw in here if you wanted, but I just used hot glue. And then took the other wicker basket and hot glued it on. And you can use like E6000 or Gorilla Glue here, whatever type of glue you want. But I think it turned out super cute, and I love it when it has the fall decorations on it. But I just think it's unique. I haven't really seen any like this at the stores. But this is all the fall decor that I'm going to be using on the tray. I wasn't sure how I was going to style it yet, so I just kind of played around with the placement. That is a pumpkin I made with just scrap fabric and grocery bags. I will link that above if you're interested in seeing how I made that. And then I'm just taking some of this greenery and kind of putting it around there. Just to give it a little bit of texture. And I have this Hello Fall sign that I picked up last year on clearance after fall. I think I got it at, you know what, I don't think it was clearance. I think I got it from Goodwill. I also got these little houses from Goodwill. They were only $1.99, which I think was a great deal. And these pumpkins are from Walmart and the Dollar Tree. Like I said, I was just playing around with placement of things. And I'm sure with how I like to change things up, I will be redoing this in some way. But I think it turned out really cute. And on to the next project. It's going to be a book pumpkin. So you just take books this size, you know, you want the center one larger and then the next one a little bit smaller and then the top one smaller than that, and you kind of want them to match the same as the bottom ones underneath the large book. And then I just mixed together some orange, cream, and white paint and painted all of them the same color. I did a few coats because some of them you could see the wording through it. And then after the paint had dried, I put a little bit of a lighter orange on there, just a few strokes, and a tiny bit of brown paint in sections just to give it a rustic look. And you can hot glue these books together, but I didn't. I figured the twine would hold them together just fine. So I wrapped twine around in two different directions. Sorry about the lighting here. And then I went and found a stick and then wrapped twine around the bottom, and I'm going to hot glue that on. And like I said, that was super, super cheap and really, really easy to do. And another book pumpkin, you're just going to take a paperback book and rip off the cover and the back and kind of fold it back and forth until you kind of make the binding really loose. And then for this, you're just going to take small sections, like a few pages, and roll it back into the center, and you're gonna use hot glue. I only did one dab of hot glue here, but I found as I went that it was easier to do a dab on the top, bottom, and middle. It just held it better. And then you just keep rolling each little section like this and tucking it in and gluing it. And then eventually you're going to end up with something that looks a little bit like a pumpkin or maybe a flower. I saw this online. I will link it in the description box if you would like to see where I originally found my inspiration. And the inspiration piece that I found, they said to use spray ink, I think it was, in yellow, but I didn't have any, so I'm just using some yellow spray paint that I had. And it also said to use like a darker ink color. And again, I didn't have the ink, so I just took a little bit of dark walnut spray paint and kind of splattered it as much as I could. I think it looks really cute like that, but I'm going to take some of the orange that I had mixed up from the last pumpkin, and I'm just kind of painting streaks on there. And then I have another stick for the stem. Kind of has a crooked base, but I went ahead and glued it on crooked anyway. And then taking a ribbon and wrapping it around, and then adding a little bit of twine. I think I might add a little bit more orange to this. And I still think it needed a little bit more, even though it's kind of cute. So I found some leaves that I had in my floral stash and hot glued it along with some more twine and kind of curled it a little bit. And just attached that with hot glue. And that's it. I think they are super cute and really unique kind of pumpkins and two-tier tray. They're very rustic, farmhouse looking. DIYs are going to be two things that were inspired by decor pieces that I saw at Joann Fabrics. The first being this fall pumpkin sign, and the second being, now don't be mad at me, it's a Christmas countdown, but I thought it was too cute to not try and duplicate. So I hope you guys enjoy. So starting off, we're going to use this wood pumpkin from the Dollar Tree and also a foam board from the Dollar Tree. And I also received this chalkboard sticker. It's a big roll from Arteza. I will link that in the description box if you guys are interested. They're not paying me for it. Like I said, with the other products, they're just having me try it out and show you guys. But you can also use chalk paint instead if you don't have this roll. But to me, this was really easy to use. So I went ahead and cut the foam board to size. And I will link sizes and stuff in the description box if you're interested in making these. And then on the back of the chalkboard sticker, it has those measurement lines. So I went ahead and used those. And I didn't cut it perfectly to fit the foam board. I tried, but I wasn't too worried about it because I knew I would put a frame on it. And I peeled off the backing like it said. And I should have started just by putting the corner down before I pulled the rest of the backing off because it did not work. So I thought I would show you the struggles that I had trying to put it on.
It's really sticky.
Yeah, I thought I could do it. But.
Okay. You want me to just match them up with the corners here?
Yeah.
Well, it's going to be a little bit longer on this side. Is that okay?
And just in time, my daughter walked in and she helped me lay it down flat. And with this stuff, it's actually really easy to work out the bubbles if you have like a card, like a credit card, or I had a squeegee. So I just pushed the bubbles out once it was laid down. So then after that, the chalkboard sticker was laid down, I went ahead and pulled off the leaf on the front of the Dollar Tree sign. And then because I liked the word thankful on there, I should have done it to all the words for future, but I just took a rubbing of the word thankful because it was a little bit raised and, you know, had the glitter, so I knew it would, you know, at least show me the outline on the rubbing so I could recreate it. So after I did that, I turned the pumpkin over and painted it white because I just wanted a plain white pumpkann because that's what I saw at Joann Fabrics. I will link the original ones that I saw too in the description box. So after I painted the pumpkin white, I went ahead and cut some small pieces of scrap wood that I had to use as the frame. And like I said, I will put measurements in the description box. And then I stained them with a little bit of a lighter stain, and then on top of that, a darker stain, just because I like the look of that better. As those were drying, I went ahead and put that thankful rubbing that I did onto the chalkboard sticker on the foam board. And I kind of pushed hard, and it didn't actually leave you know, the pencil marks on there like I thought it would, but thankfully it left an imprint to where I could go ahead and use these chalkboard markers that Arteza sent me as well. And these are awesome. I love them. You can use chalk or whatever you want, because I thought this was a great idea using the chalkboard markers or chalk. Actual chalk, because then you can go ahead and change the sign out whenever you want. You can just lift up the pumpkin and change the word thankful and write something for Christmas or birthdays or whatever. I like when signs and decor can be interchangeable. So anyway, I went ahead and traced the imprint with the marker, and I'm gonna leave it just the outline. At first I was gonna fill it in, but my daughter loved it like this, so I thought it would be cool to leave it. And now I'm just making sure the frame fits, and you can go ahead and use like a frame from a store or something. You don't have to make your own. You could also probably get another foam board and just make a frame out of that. That would probably work. So anyway, I went ahead and used Gorilla Glue and hot glue to attach the frame to the sign. And this is very lightweight, so this could be hung easily with, I don't know, a tack or something. So after the pumpkin was dry, I went ahead and just drew in some lines to give it a little bit of definition. And then I hot glued it onto the sign. And for the little holes, you can put, putty or glue or anything that you can paint over. Well, thanks so much for watching, guys. If you're new here, I would love for you to join my YouTube family. If you're returning, you know I love all of you, and I love to chit-chat in the comments if you get a chance. So keep a lookout, because I'm going to have some new fall DIYs coming out. Also, if I get a chance, I will do a part two of my favorites. I hope you all have a great day. Take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye!